Someone breaks into your home in the middle of the night. It's dark. And they tell you they're going to rob you. You have a Louisville Slugger. And you whack them across the head. They fall down. They go to the hospital. They get arrested. You think that's the end of it. And then you get sued. But you're not worried, because you've got homeowners insurance. Well, maybe you should be. I'll explain in just a moment. Whether you use a baseball bat to protect your house or one of these, the fact is that in almost every instance, and certainly in most states, if you use any kind of a weapon in self-defense of your property, you are probably taking yourself out of protection of your homeowner's policy. Insurance policies are written in a specific way. They start with a bunch of definitions. All these terms mean the following things in the context of this particular policy. You need to read those. And once you know what those definitions are, then you will look at what's called the covered perils. These are the things that your liability or other insurance provides protection against in the course of your life. Following those, however, and perhaps even more important than the coverage portion of your policy, are the exclusions. These are the oh by the way kinds of things that say, oh by the way, we are not going to cover you for intentional acts. So let's unpack that just a little bit. When the gentleman comes through your door armed with a big machete and he tells you he's going to cut your head off and rob you, and you whack him with that ball bat, when you swing that bat, that's an intentional act. Now, it may have been thrust upon you by virtue of the fact that you're being attacked with a machete, but it's still an intentional act. And if Brutus, who is now laying on the floor and is, you know, requires medical attention, goes to the hospital and he gets, you know, arrested for breaking and entering and carrying a weapon, and he does 18 months in the county jail, he comes out and he decides to sue you, your insurance company is going to say, whoa, no, wait a minute, buddy. I'm sorry. Here's the deal. Your coverage is excluded because you hit him. That was an intentional act on your part. And you may be thinking, well, it wasn't really intentional. I had no choice. Oh, no, you did have a choice. It could be your head laying on the floor instead of, you know, Brutus's body laying on the floor. That was a choice. It's not a good choice for you, but it was a choice, right? This is how insurance companies think. And more importantly, this is how insurance companies often act. So it's important. It's even vital, I would say, for you to understand what the limitations are on your homeowner's insurance. That's one reason why, although self-defense tools, you know, whether they're firearms or knives or some other thing, are often a good secondary method of protecting your home, it is far better to have good lighting, very strong door locks, an alarm system, and cameras. We use the Blink cameras. Now, this is not a plug for Amazon or any of their products. I'm simply telling you that we use the Blink camera system, and it works quite well. It keeps us informed of whenever anybody comes up to the front or back doors or goes to our garage. This is very important because those are the places most likely to be entry points for somebody threatening to commit some kind of violent home intrusion. As a result, we believe that we are better protected, and it helps us to ensure that more likely than not, somebody is going to see those cameras and walk away, because they know if they're on camera that there's a very high likelihood that eventually they'll be caught. It's important also to remember that the reason people steal and commit home invasions is because they don't want to work, So if you make it so that they have to work hard, most of the time they won't work hard. They'll go to the next easy victim. They are not looking for a fight. They're looking for a victim. And that's an important thing for you to remember. But it's also important to remember that your insurance policy has exclusions and that there are ways to buy other coverages so that you can protect yourself. For example, many firearm owners will use the United States Concealed Carry Association and purchase coverage and protection from them. That's an exceptionally good thought for people who don't want to be left holding the bag if they were required on some dark and stormy night to have to shoot someone who kicked their way through their front door. I hope you found this helpful and interesting. And if you would, I'd appreciate it if you'd smash that like button and click on the notification bell so that you'd be notified whenever I post a video on the law. Thank you very much and have a terrific day.